An incandescent bulb. For many years, this was the only type of electric light you could buy. Now, thanks to new technologies, there are a variety of lighting options: halogen, compact fluorescent, LED. Without the right information, it can be difficult to make the right buying decisions. Which light uses the least energy? Which are the best for the environment? Which are the most cost-effective? And are all the objects illuminated by these lights going to look the same? With the right equipment, we can find the answer to all of these questions. This is a power meter, which measures the energy consumption of electrical devices. When the incandescent light is turned on, the power meter shows that it draws 57 watts. A watt is a measure of how much work is being done per second. The bulb converts this energy into light. The illumination, that is, the amount of light reaching the object, is measured in lux. The assembled light fixtures provide the same amount of illumination, whether they are incandescent, compact fluorescent, or LED. Because the illumination is the same, it is easy to determine which light uses the least power to achieve the same illumination. Here we have a halogen lamp, a type of incandescent lamp that uses halogen gas to extend the life of the bulb. However, because it is still a type of incandescent light, it uses roughly as many watts as the standard incandescent bulb. This is a compact fluorescent light, or CFL. For many years, fluorescent lights were only available in long, unwieldy tubes. But in recent years, small home versions have become available. As you can see, the CFL only uses 11 watts to create the same level of illumination as the incandescent and halogen lights, making it 5 times more efficient. Though less common than CFLs, it is also possible to use LEDs as a light source. Early LEDs had limited light output, but modern versions can easily rival the illumination of a standard bulb. This LED, giving the same illumination as the incandescent and compact fluorescent lights, uses only 9 watts. This is less than the CFL and 6 times less than the incandescent bulb. From this, it is easy to see that LED lighting is by far the most energy efficient, followed closely by CFLs. However, this is not the only advantage of these kind of lights. In addition to drawing less energy, CFLs and LEDs have longer lifespans than incandescent bulbs. A CFL will last 6,000 to 15,000 hours, and an LED can last as much as 50,000, compared to only 1,200 hours for an incandescent bulb. Thus, because they use much less energy and last much longer, LEDs and CFLs are much better for the environment. However, LED lighting is currently quite expensive. The LED seen here is about $40. As such, CFLs are the most common and eco-friendly light available. Wattage and lifespan are not the only differences between these types of lights. Although they all look the same, each emits different amounts of light at each wavelength. These differences affect how we see the colors of the illuminated object. Though the difference is too subtle to be shown on film with these conventional lighting fixtures, it can be easily demonstrated with these two yellow lights and a bouquet of flowers. Here, we have a yellow-painted incandescent light and a sodium lamp. They both give off a yellow light, but where the yellow incandescent gives us nearly a full range of color, the sodium lamp only shows the flowers in shades of gray. This is because the sodium lamp emits light in only a narrow wavelength of light. The result is that two similar looking lights show colors in a dramatically different way. While the white lights we showed earlier differ in a more subtle way, we should still remember that there is a difference in quality of light. Though there isn't currently a fully agreed upon numerical measure of quality, most people would agree it's important to choose lights that cause the colors of objects to appear natural and pleasing to the eye.